In the belly of hell, Jonas in their 3 days and three nights. I don't imagine that he started his prayer the third day. I don't imagine he started his prayer the second day. But I imagine within 5 minutes of being in the belly of a fish.
Go ahead, that's it.
His mouth, even if it didn't open up because of the stench, and too afraid that I can't see my own hand in front of my face, and if I open my mouth, something might get in, but his mind cries, Lord, it's because of my affliction.
My own.
How often do we stop in our own tracks, living our own lives, and say, Lord, I'm crying to you because you are the only one that can get me out of this. As unpreferred as every situation I seem to encounter is, I still know you're the God of gods.
Yes.
You're the Lord of hosts, the King of my salvation,
yes,
the Savior of my soul. And if you could just give me one chance to take my vow for your name's sake, if you don't do it for me, do it because you sent the word out. If you don't do it because I need it, because I deserve it, do it because you've invested so much in me that it has to come to pass.
Come on, sir. Come on, sir.
Say it.
Oh, you preacher.
That fish had no choice.
No choice.
But to open its mouth and vomit Jonah.
Thank you, Lord.
The next time you see someone doing something that they shouldn't be doing, the next time you hear someone saying something that they shouldn't be saying, the next time you see someone acting the way they shouldn't be acting, think first. That might be the Nineveh that God is sending you to. And before you quickly walk in the other direction, before you quickly say it's somebody else, it just might be brought to your attention. Because it's God showing you where you need to deliver salvation. The Bible says, Jonah says, salvation is of the Lord, and I will pay the vow that I have vowed. And if you can just get to the point that